To the motherfucking neighborhood. I'm sitting in my whip, trying to get my day started. Welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. If it's your first time in the motherfucking neighborhood, make sure you bring it back to the bottom of the map. Make sure you go and see a video. Well, make sure you start from the beginning of the journey. Go to the video called Welcome to the Neighborhood. That's what how this started. And then watch from the beginning, Welcome to the Neighborhood, until where you came in on the journey. Maybe if you came in the middle of the journey, watch all the way to the end. This is the story of the journey of where God's taking me in my life. I'm giving you gems along the way. I'm giving you unbiased political. I'm giving you financial advice. I'm giving you all the things that I learned along the way so that you won't have to do that shit yourself. If it worked for me, I tell you. If it failed for me, I'll tell you. I done failed a lot. I done a lot. And so, like, I'm just trying to do it before you do it. So I can do the experiment and I can tell you if it worked or not. If you want to know about the channel and why I started it and why I'm doing what I'm doing, go to a video called The Thing About Hope. All right, guys. Real quick, I don't know if you can see this. So this is my new tattoo. I know it's like real, like, first off, I got a like clear band-aid on it, but that's the tenon circle cross of tenon. I got that yesterday. I got my poly yesterday, and I have one on the inside of my arm. And it says behind enemy lines. So I got those yesterday. Shout out to Elissa at fucking Canvas Tattoo. She a boss bitch. I told her I was gonna shout her out, so I'm gonna work on it. I got a piece on my leg. I'm gonna get her to do my leg piece for me. I told her she the artist and she's a bum ass artist, so I told her to just be thinking of shit, and as I stack my cake, we gonna do a little leg piece to go with my, I got a queen chest piece on the bed of yin and yang on my leg, and so we gonna turn that into a masterpiece. I'm sorry, y'all, got something flurry on my nose. All right, so it's 9:37. I have to, bitch, and I'm feeling myself. Like, I'm feeling myself. It's so crazy, especially like, and I'm gonna be honest with you, especially women. And when I take my hair out, like, sometimes I'll be like, am I gonna still think it's cute? Bitch, yes, you know? Like, but I'm human. Those are things that people think, and that's something that I definitely think sometimes. Cause I love big hair, and I chopped off all of my hair, maybe 2 years ago. After I told you guys I had some miscarriages, I had a miscarriage and two abortions, and I'll talk about that with you guys later. Man, speaking of miscarriage and two abortions, I can't wait to do my politically incorrect. I'm gonna do a politically incorrect today. The first debate was yesterday, and it's so much I want to talk about. It probably will be a very unpopular opinion, but an opinion nonetheless. They're gonna be biased points. They're gonna be unbiased points, but I can't wait to talk to you guys about it, because that shit was crazy. And it's crazy because when I was in high school, one of my civics teacher, I can't remember his name. I know he had a gym in Central. One of my favorite teachers, I can't think of his fucking name, but Mr. O'Brien, shout out to you too. He was one of my history teachers as well. But they used to make us watch political debates. So I've been watching debates since I was like 13 or 14. And so to watch last night's debate, which was fucking monumental, which was fucking historic. Like, people get upset with Trump. I'm not a huge Trump fan. Like I told you, I'm physically conservative and everything else pretty fucking liberal. But Trump, whether like Hitler, and fuck Hitler. He somebody should have like killed him, brought him back to life, killed him, brought him back to life, killed him, brought him back to life, and like 1,000 times a day. But Hitler, we know who that nigga is. Hitler been dead for years and years and years, and we know who that nigga is, even though he was worse than trash juice. And I feel like Trump know what he doing. Like, he picked his side. He said, I'm gonna work for the bad side, but I'm going to motherfucking, I'm a make history. And if you don't think Trump bad, that's okay too. I don't hate you because you like Trump. Like, I understand why people like Trump, because it is what it is. You don't necessarily have to be a racist to like Trump. I ain't one of the people. This ain't the channel for that shit. No judgment. But very, very fucking interesting. I have to run in the store. I gotta get some. So crazy. I didn't think I was gonna have enough money for my tattoo, because I told y'all I fucked up my money. I had more than enough money for my tattoo. I ended up being able to tip the young lady very nicely, and I have enough money to just kind of go get a few groceries to tie me over to Friday. Gotta work some shit out for you. He'll work it out. Work it out, work it out. But like I said, make sure your canvas tattoo, Alicia, Elisa, E-L-I-S-A, Sanchez, I believe that's her last name. She thinks she bad, she a cutie. So she cute. Well, my eyes was closed. I almost bit the top of my lip off when she was doing this bitch, and it ain't even that huge. But Boss tattoo artist. So make sure you guys check her out. But so I gotta run in the store. I got a catch up with one of my coworkers, and I gotta chat with my mentor today. And then I gotta hop to work. I gotta clean my house, and I gotta work out all before 12 o'clock today. Y'all pray for me. I'm trying to not work too much, but still work. Y'all, it's interesting. I forgot I had a birthday party this weekend, so I'll be doing that. I gotta find something cute. My homegirl, she just a little rich. She rich. She's snooty and she rich, and I love her. I love her crazy ass, and I love her class. So you guys will see that. But real quick, I wanted to talk about being a change agent. And then, like, when I say real quick, I mean más rápido. Being a change agent. To everybody who is a change agent, whatever you look like, change agents come in different forms and fashions. Neo look different for it, depending upon whatever it is you're doing. So that could be my preachers, that could be my teachers, that could be my doctors, that could be my lawyers, that could be my human rights activists, that could be my mothers, that could be my fathers. Anybody who is a change agent, please, there's one thing I want you to understand. Please, 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 please check them for a while. Oh, ill, please, 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 please don't let them niggas near me. Please, please hear me when I say this. You got the hardest job in the world. And if you are not okay with chaos, if you are not okay with destruction, if you are not okay with pushback, if you are not okay with people being mad at you, if you are not okay with people hating you, if you are not okay with pain, if you are not okay with fighting, if you are not okay with tears, you're in the wrong profession. You're not called to do this. This ain't for everybody. And just because you're not a change agent don't mean you don't have a place in the world, because everybody got a motherfucking place in the world. But this shit get messy. Messy, messy. Like Messy Maya, bitch. Shout out to Messy Maya. She was murked in fucking New Orleans. Fucking Magnolia Shorty. Shout out to Magnolia Shorty. These are just all things that people and places that I come from that, you know, that I watched growing up that fucking influenced me. But if you are any of those things, or you are an influencer, you gotta understand there's some hoes that ain't gonna like you, and they not gonna like you, and some people placing the things that not gonna like you, not for any particular reason, just cause you, just cause you fucking woke up this morning, just cause you got on motherfucking glasses, just cause you got on motherfucking hoops, just cause you got a motherfucking nose ring, just cause you motherfucking talk, bitch. And don't be a minority, bitch. You just already, you coming into the motherfucking fight at a disadvantage. But you gotta know that, and that's what I want you to know. And when you know that, it's not anything to be mad about, it's not anything to be upset about, it's not anything to be offended about, it's just something to be aware of. And once you're aware of your weakness, you know how to move. It's like boxing. Like, if I know I got a weak left, I know I got a fucking control in my right, you know what I'm saying? So I just want to give you, I want to put you up on hustle gang, I want to put you up on hustle game. Like, I want to put you up on change agent game. And I feel so crazy even saying this, because, man, I'm the type of person who always wants to be universally liked. I'm the type of person who just be like, why don't they like me? I just want them to be my friend. I just want to love him. But I realize and it's not a cocky thing. This is not a anything, but it's just a real thing. And for my people in tarot, I'll explain it to people outside of tarot land. Like, I am a walking tarot moment. Anything I say to you, anything I say or do will fuck you up. And the crazy thing is, I don't be trying to fuck you up, because most of the time, and I had to learn this by myself, I don't know that I'm fucking people up. I don't know that I fucked somebody up until they didn't cuss me the fuck out because I didn't say something that offended them. Or years later, they come down the line and say, hey, you really, really helped me. Or you really, really changed my mind. Or you really, really changed my thoughts. But you're going to make people uncomfortable. And one of the things with my job, I told you guys, I sit on a diversity committee. A lot of people ask me, how can I talk about these uncomfortable situations or uncomfortable topics and not get emotional? Because I was built for this shit. I was built for that pressure. I forgive you, Kevin Gates, for us. I was built for this shit. So when you built for the terrain that you're in, when you're built to be a chameleon, when you're built for every environment you go into, you can't shake. But let me tell you, it was a process to be built. Like, this motherfucking, you know, to turn into who I am and what I am, that shit ain't easy. That shit wasn't easy. That shit hard. That shit hurt. That shit sucked. But I did it. And the crazy thing is, I'm only 31, and I know I got, and I know I have so many more people to help. And so that means more pain and more heartache and more disappointments. But now I welcome it. It's like, yes, more tools to help people with. And when you look at pain and the world and lost and disparity and I'm looking for the word disparage. I don't think that's the correct word. Like, when you look at it like that, man, your outlook on your life is so much different. So every time I come into a piece of pain, every time I come into a heartbreak, I'll be like, oh man, I can't wait to teach somebody what I learned from this shit. Especially the bigger the battle, I'll be like, and it's so crazy because I always say that to myself. I'll be like, God, I know I'm going to something good. Have you motherfucking, I know whatever the fuck I just went through. Like, I knew, ain't no God. You know, I know I'm going to help somebody with this shit. So, my change agents, my hustlers, my, you know, like, you go through things. Don't, when you go through something, especially if you are an influencer, if you're a change agent, don't be mad about that shit. You're supposed to. Like, that's, like it's like training for the job, guys. It's like most people, you know, when you get a new job, you go through training. They teach you. Some people do 6 weeks of training. Some people do 6 months of training. And then after they go to training, they do the job. Well, being an influencer or a change agent, your life is constant training for the job that God has set for you. I need to ask her, can we push it back? And you are a constant change agent. You're constantly learning. You're constantly learning new ways to help the people that you were encounter along this life. Don't fucking forget that. I know it get hard. But when you look at how hard it get, when you look at the things that you go through, when you look at all those things, and then when I look back over my life, hey, and I think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I got a testimony. Bitch, I went old school church on that ass. When you look back over your life and all the things that you thought the devil meant for your bad and you realize God meant it for your good, man, you got a testimony. Bitch, you know how many people you can help with a testimony? Motherfucking money. Look up the word testimony. That's some old stomp clap black church shit. You know, and that's where I grew up, bitch. So there's that. So that's what I wanted to talk to you guys about. My change agents keep up. Keep it up. You got this. Every test is a testimony. Every test is a piece of training to prepare you for who you're going to help and what level you're going to. And the higher the level, the bigger the devil. Boosie said that shit, I believe. So just, you know, keep going. Understand that it's all a part of, it's a part of your job. It's a part of your calling. And you built for that shit. God not gonna ever put more on you than you could fucking bear. So I'm gonna take us out on one of my favorite shits, my favorite songs. I was singing this the other day, but my favorite, my change agents do this shit. Fresh, dress, like a 16, 18. Black bandana music and lip boots. Fresh, dress, fresh, dress. 6'3G and lip boots. Looking, feeling like a $1 million, 'cause I was fresh, dress, fresh, dress, dress. See, I was in that club.
tip on the scene. Too clean. Fresh to death in the earth tone, Miss Skeen.
All right, guys. Happy motherfucking hump day. Happy hump day. Go motherfucking get it, because if you don't, you already fucking know. Somebody else will. Hey, this my shit, y'all. The Alabama.